Welcome back, Ocoee Region. I am so glad I have some guests here today that's going to talk about an awesome organization called Scenic City Women's Network. And I had the pleasure and opportunity to go to one of their luncheons last year. But I don't want to give it away because I have here Renee Nail, Executive Director, and Phyllis James, Board President. And I'm going to have them share with you the mission and vision and all sorts of stuff about the Scenic City Women's Network. So, Renee, go ahead.
Well, thank you so much, Tony, for having us. Yes. We are so excited. It's so good to see you again.
Yes.
But the mission of Scenic City Women's Network is first and foremost to encourage, equip, and energize Christian working women.
Yes.
And with that vision is so that she can be all she can be in Christ Jesus. So.
Amen. I was so excited. Yvonne Harvey, as you all know, works with you guys, and she was the one that connected me and invited me to a luncheon, and I just want to give a shout out to her today, send her some love, and that we are lifting her up. With prayer regarding her mom and her family situation. And so I just want to say that. But tell me how the Scenic City Women's Network, how does this really work?
Well, first of all, it got started back in 94.
Yes.
And what's so interesting about its startup is that it was actually the idea of a man as opposed to a woman. And he was looking at all the different organizations in Chattanooga and seeing how much there was out there in the way of men's ministries and or men's fellowship groups and said, hey, why don't we have a women's group? So we owe him a great deal of thanks. it was really his concept. But, you know, from that, a small group of women, Christian women in the workplace, started to lay the foundation for this organization. And really the idea behind it was that it was going to provide a venue, a place, a safe place, so to speak, where women who were in the marketplace could come together during the course of the week and have fellowship and find support for one another working through some of the issues that they have as working women. Because we all know the pressures that are on working women in the marketplace. You know, all the multitasking, the things that women face, both either whether it's as a being a good mother, being a good Christian, being a good career person, you know, being involved in the school if there are children, and again, providing a good home, a safe environment.
All and trying to be involved in her church.
Yes.
You know, because you spend, working women spend 70% of their time in the workplace. And so juggling all that she's juggling with school, whether it's homework or soccer games, whether it's being in the PTA, plus the home life, it's a lot. And then for her to find a chance to plug into her church, many times time and proximity won't allow it. You know, if she works downtown and her church is across town, she's got a certain amount of time for her lunch. So that's where Scenic City comes in.
So in that beginning, the idea was, this is what we want to do for women, but now how do we do it?
Yes.
And so, of course, it was at that point starting to test and build programs that we thought would support women and finding the places in where they could go and it would be convenient, and then at the same time finding a time slot where we weren't actually adding more pressure to them, but again meeting them where they are. And that was, I would say that was really the seed. That was the, you know, the original concept that even today still drives our programs and drives what we do to try to support women and help them grow in their faith. In other words, to mature as Christians, even though they're not able to get to all the different church activities that are occurring during the week, and especially those that support women, you know, as well.
Yes.
So ours has been an ever-evolving organization, and it is one that, you know, and we've seen our membership grow as a result of that.
Yeah. How large is the membership?
We have about 120 women. Wow. That are part of it. And then we have even more than that that come as guests to our luncheons, or maybe they'll guest.
Exactly. And to give you an idea, we actually reach over 1,000 women. We have over 1,000 women that are on our email list that have either been in our organization at one time or another, been members, because we actually, because our organization, once we connect to a woman, even when she has moved on, whether it be out of state, you know, she's actually relocated to a new home, and or she is ill, not able to continue to be an active member, we still stay very involved with our email activities also. So we reach.
And that's one of our ministry programs, actually, is every Monday in her inbox when she gets to work will be a meditation to encourage her through her day and just lift her spirit. So they get that. And then, of course, 1 week a month is our newsletter that just they're actually hearing from me. And so what's happening in the ministry and what is the next upcoming thing. So, and then we always list where Bible studies, where they can find a Bible study or where they can meet for networking opportunities. Because, you know, that's another thing. Mm-hmm. And the program area is networking.
Yes.
You know, so many times working women feel isolated, you know, because they're doing their job, and as soon as the job's over, they got to go.
Go home and do the other job.
Right, exactly.
Yes.
So we want those networking opportunities, even if it's through social media, so that she can find a connection and realize that she's not out there alone. You know, many times you feel like you're that lone woman in a boat, so to speak, trying to juggle so much. So that networking, social media, is a way to keep that connection wherever she is, if she's relocated or if she's finding herself at home for a season.
So let me get this straight. So when I think of the types of program that this organization offers, there's Bible studies, there's email support, devotion, meditation, whatever. There's prayer.
Absolutely.
Come on. I knew there was one we left out. The whole purpose of this
is prayer. It's one of our foundations.
It was founded in prayer. It's sustained. We have a prayer team of about 35 ladies that pray. And so when somebody shares a prayer request, we actually will send it to the prayer team and they will pray for that prayer request. Our board, at every board meeting, we will break down the membership list and we will pray name by name over the ladies and even the churches. We're praying for those churches too. So it's foundational to the ministry.
Yes.
It's something that we do that we get constant feedback on is every one of our members during the course of the year will get one or two prayer cards. And in other words, as we rotate through at these monthly meetings and we're praying for each of our members and or the community and or the churches, then we follow up with a prayer card. And so that goes out to each member and or to the churches.
Right.
And the feedback, you know, I can't tell you how many times we either get a telephone call, get an email, and or our next luncheon, you know, I received my prayer card. You know, you don't know, like it came just at the right time, you know, or this was going on. And, you know, the idea that you had lifted me up in prayer. I mean, those kinds of testimonies, those kinds of stories, those are what we live for, you know, with our ministry and the programs that we provide. And then in addition to that, we actually have added on now what we call webinars, whereby we are meeting women at their desk and or at home, Skyping in and providing different topics that we have heard back through surveys. These are things we want addressed with regard to additional help in the way of education and or encouragement and energizing.
And then also we have a prayer walk where we walk through the city and pray for our city.
Yes.
You know, because that, when you pray for your city, for the welfare of the city, you
the
find
leaders.
Your own welfare when you pray like that. And so we pray for our leaders, for the business executives, and then we hear back from them too.
Yeah. And just to give you an idea, show you how God works, you know, in His own way. We're at our last prayer walk, and we're downtown Chattanooga in the city, on the streets, and who do we run into? the mayor of the city. I mean, again, you know, that doesn't just happen.
No.
You know, that
there are no coincidences with God.
Exactly.
Ordained moments.
Right.
Exactly.
Yes.
So
yes.
true. So true.
And he was just so warm when we said, we want you to know, we have prayed for you. We have prayed for your office.
Yes.
And he just genuinely was thankful for that. So, and how much better of a workplace has it become for a woman when you have prayed for her workplace?
Yes.
And her CEO knows it.
Yes.
And on that particular prayer walk, we were able to intervene with two homeless people as well. So, I mean, again, you know, the benefits are unending. The stories are unending, you know, when you are out there, you know, on the street for God. So.
Well, one of I wanted to say this because I love this ministry. I love the way it is positioned. I love it that it is a marketplace ministry. God has so put that on my heart that, you know, we have got to take him out.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
And it's an example of what Jesus did.
Yes.
He went out into the city, into the villages,
exactly.
And
I
he
did.
Walked, and he prayed, and he saved, and he healed. And God has put that on my heart so much, and it's just awesome to see an organization that has put a focus on the marketplace, and in particular through women in that marketplace. And I'm loving everything that you're doing, the webinar, that is really great because that helps even more with I can, you know, sit at my desk or I can sit at home and I can connect in to a community. But the other thing I also love is the whole foundation of prayer around this organization and the opportunity, though, to come face-to-face and network on a monthly basis at your monthly lunches and things like that. So if I or other women like me would love to get involved with Scenic City Women's Network, what are the membership requirements?
Well, it's really quite simple. You can access us through our website. You can access us, of course, by phone and by email. And it's only $50 a year to be a member. And, you know, with that comes, you know, benefits. But it's a very simple process as far as application. It can be done online and or it can be done at our monthly luncheons. It's very easy to, you know, to get to us. And at the same time, you know, the benefits are numerous with regard to what we provide then in the way of additional support and some other, really some other financial monetary incentives as well in the way of discounts, you know, things that we have in the way of support from our different companies who do support Scenic City Women's Network. So we would love to have any and everyone. Website is scwn.org. Very simple.
Yes.
scwn.org.
We can pull up a copy of that too to show you on screen.
We have
the website.
We have the actual screen up, and you can
there is a
there.
Section to make a prayer request as well.
Yes.
So if you
you can go online and make a prayer request. These ladies do so much for our region. I won't say your reach is just Scenic City. It does reach out.
Yes.
And I'd like to encourage those that could because, I mean, there's enough with the website, with webinars, with it doesn't matter where you locate it. You can become a part of this. And, you know, we all travel to check. Come on now, y'all. And so we can schedule our time to come in and be a part of the luncheon and all of that.
And even, and as you say, even if you can't physically get to the monthly luncheons, there is still so much that is available through the website and or through our email contact.
Yes.
I mean, really, in this day and age, you know, everything, so much is being done online, and that is one of the evolvements. We have now become much more accessible via our online approach to our organization. So, yes, you can be a member and not have to come to the monthly luncheons and still
That's
take
right.
advantage of a lot of services and programs that we offer.
And we know I'm part of a nonprofit organization, and in fact I've been on that side for the last 10 years. And so we know there are expenses and things like that, and that we have to raise money. You are a nonprofit organization. So when we're going to take a break, and when we come back, we're going to share with the community your up and coming fundraiser. And I'm not going to give it away yet, okay? But this is exciting. Ladies, I'm going. And I got my good friend going with me. But if anybody else, when I come back, you're going to want to join me and take a trip.
I think so.
Okay?
Absolutely.
Take a trip to the 2017 Praise Breakfast.
Rah, rah, yes.
Okay? And chat. So we'll be right back.
My passion is outdoors, but my knees reached a point where I just couldn't enjoy it as well, so I had knee replacement surgery at Tenova. My experience was excellent. My new knees are great. They work well, I have no pain, and I'm able to do all the things that I enjoy.
If joint pain is affecting your life, find out how Tenova can help. Come to a free joint pain seminar. Register today at TenovaOrtho.com.
Time for a home improvement? Need to consolidate some debt? Want to talk face-to-face with a local lender about the options available to you? If you answered yes, then it's time to contact the financial professionals at Andrew Johnson Bank and talk to them about a home equity loan. There are no closing costs for those who qualify and low interest rates based on credit. Andrew Johnson Bank, the local lender you need. The local bank you can trust.
When I was denied my Social Security benefits, I turned to the legal professionals at Logan Thompson Law. When it mattered to me, I chose Logan Thompson. Logan Thompson, attorneys at law, when it matters.
Welcome to Nissan of Cleveland. Stop by our showroom today to take a look at the amazing vehicles we have for sale, like the brand new Nissan Maxima and the V8 Titan. Check out our imagination bar where you can view our entire inventory in real time. Also, our dedicated service specialists are here to ensure your vehicle is repaired and on the road in no time. Here at Nissan of Cleveland, our Sonic pricing ensures that you receive a fair, competitive price on your new vehicle, and we back that with a lifetime warranty. Nissan of Cleveland, located just off exit 20 on I-75.
When I was accused of a crime, my liberty was hanging in the balance. My legal rights matter to me, so I went to the professionals at Logan Thompson Law. Logan Thompson, attorneys at law, when it matters.
Unlike the other guys, Toyota Express Maintenance ensures there are two skilled technicians working on your Toyota instead of just one. That means you'll get more services in the same amount of time it takes the other guys to do whatever it is they're doing. Schedule your appointment now at your local Toyota Express Maintenance Service Center.
The ReStore has kept over 3,250 tons of materials out of our local landfill since 2004. This has extended the life of the landfill and saved Bradley County taxpayers a tremendous amount of money.
The ReStore opens up endless possibilities to turn trash into treasure through do-it-yourself repurposing of ReStore items. It's fun to repurpose, restore, and recycle items that would otherwise be trash.
Welcome back, Ocoee Region. We are so excited. As you well know, I've been talking with Renee and Phyllis about Scenic City Women's Network. And as we went to commercial, we said we had an announcement to make about a great fundraiser that they are having. And I'm just going to turn it over to you guys and have you tell the community who you all are bringing to Chattanooga real soon.
Well, we are so excited for this year's prayer breakfast. You know, every year we have a theme, mm-hmm. and this year the theme for Scenic City is the power of prayer in the marketplace.
Oh, I love it.
After all, that's what we're founded in, and you know, you've seen this movement of prayer across our nation. So when we began to talk and pray about who should we have for this praise breakfast, I said, why not the prayer warrior herself?
Miss Clara.
We were so just praying that we could get a hold of her and that she would be available. And so Karen Abercrombie is the actress, yes. and she is going to reprise her role as Miss Clara, and we are offering coffee with Miss Clara at our praise breakfast.
Oh, I love it.
And I have to tell you, we're a small organization, so we knew we were dreaming big, okay?
Okay.
And it took quite a while for us to go back and forth working through her schedule and finding something that would work for us as well. And so again, you know, we know this is it's God answered our prayer, and we know that she has a very special message that he is empowering her with that she will be bringing to Chattanooga and to all who are here. So we're just extremely ecstatic about her being here. This is like a very big event. And I want to point out that she will be making her presentation in character.
Okay.
That's important for everybody to know and understand.
Because okay? We all love us some Miss Clara.
Oh, yes.
Now, when is the date of this event?
It's April 13th. It's okay. On a Thursday morning, mm-hmm. and it's at the Chattanooga Convention Center. The doors open at 6:30, and the buffet line will be open then, too. And then the program will start promptly at 7 a.m.
7 a.m. Mm-hmm. And so if I want to buy tickets.
Mm-hmm. The tickets are $30 each, and that does include your breakfast. And it does, of course, include the presentation. And we will be prompt to finish at 9 o'clock at the latest. She will probably finish up about 8:45. So for those working women who have to slip out, you know, they can exit a few minutes early. But you can buy your tickets, again, back to our website. You can actually buy online at scwn.org. Or, of course, you can call our number, 423-698-6262, and can purchase tickets by phone as well. So either online or by phone, if that's your preference.
And email. You can always email
us. That's true. You can
email
and request it and do it by mail. That's very true.
admin@scwn.org.
Well, I want to take a few minutes with you guys here in the studio, and I just want to play a clip.
Okay.
Awesome.
Right.
All right, so why don't we do that right now?
Super.
You've done it again, Lord. You've done it again. You are good and you are mighty and you are merciful. And you keep taking care of me when I don't deserve it. Praise you, Jesus. You are Lord. Give me another one, Lord. Guide me to who you want me to help. Raise up more that will call upon your name. Raise up those that love you and seek you and trust you. Raise them up, Lord, raise them up. Lord, we need a generation of believers who are not ashamed of the gospel. We need an army of believers, Lord, that hate to be lukewarm and will stand on your word above all else. Raise them up, Lord, raise them up. I pray for unity among those that love you. I pray that you open their eyes so that they can see your truth, Lord. I pray for your hand of protection and guidance. Raise up a generation, Lord, that will take light into this world, that will not compromise when under pressure, that will not cower, Lord, when others fall away. Raise them up, Lord, that they will proclaim that there is salvation in the name of Jesus Christ. Raise up warriors, Lord, who will fight on their knees, who will worship you with their whole hearts, Lord. Lord, call us to battle, that we may proclaim you King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I pray these things with all my heart. Raise them up, Lord, raise them up.
Wow. Wow.
It still gives me goosebumps to hear that prayer.
Me too. And I let it play the whole part. He kept looking at me like, are you going to call it? And I couldn't. Yeah. I just had to let the whole thing. And she's going to be there in character on April 13th. Yes. I'm telling you guys, this prayer breakfast at this time, with her coming to this region, I just feel it in my heart that it would ignite a power move for the glory of God.
We feel that. We're praying for that. There are so many other signs and signals that we're seeing across the nation right now that if we can bring it to Chattanooga, to the Scenic City area, we feel that this does. It is the impetus for a movement that only God knows where it will go. Mm-hmm. Only God knows.
That's our hope, is to ignite the power of prayer in the marketplace right here in our hometown.
And I love that. And I'm saying to the women of Ocoee region, let's get behind this. Let's get our tickets. Let's, you know, those that are from this area, let's caravan and go down and be with Scenic City Women's Network and Miss Clara on April 13th. Thank you guys for coming.
Thank you for having us.
A pleasure having you here today, and I promise I'll be back at a meeting, okay?
We're counting on it.
Thank you so much.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Hey, that's a wrap for Hidden Gems of Ocoee Region. Thank you for joining me this morning, and have a great, great First Friday.